Hello, hello, hello. See if I can, we're on it. If you've jumped on, say hi. Hey, Ricky. Thanks for joining. Hopefully the lighting is better tonight. He had the boxes on the right lights now. I'm gonna grab my cup we're gonna be starting on. Let's see how my water is. It's pretty good. Hello, hi Dusty. Thanks for joining. Hey MS Scales 505, good evening. You see it? We're gonna do some decals, we're gonna do some full wraps, and I think we got a glitter cup that we might get to.
I see Groot. You already said it. You see it. Hi, Dusty.
We're putting your decals on.
Hi, Ricky.
Mr. Turtle joined. So we're gonna put these water slides on the half and half cup. They're gonna be so cool. And we're gonna do a full wrap. We're gonna work on the St. Patty's Day. We got a murder show on. Mulan, we're gonna be adding flowers to it. We got lots of stuff going on.
Hi, Michael.
Genie79, hello. Thanks for joining. We're gonna put these decals. D. Lene, hey, hey. We're gonna put these decals on those cups that we were doing. I can't wait.
Brown Eyes 6518, hi.
Hello. So yeah, we're gonna put our Groot Venom decal on. Isn't that going to be amazing? Yeah, we're going to put these decals on tonight, and this is going to be amazing. I can't wait. They're going to look so cool.
Academic Ferret, ooh, love your sweatshirt.
Thank you.
Scrappy Girl 1993, hey, just got home from a Girl Scout meeting.
Oh, excellent. I just saw a funny little meme or whatever. What do they call those? Memes, whatever, of the Girl Scouts from somebody in our neighborhood. It says, we know you've been clean almost a year, but your dealer's back on the streets. And it was a Girl Scout cookie. Out selling your cookies. It was so cute. I was like, I'm going to go buy some just because of that. That was adorable. Hey, Ricky, I saw that. Thank you for sending the presents. You'll be entered into that monthly drawing for a free tumbler of your choice. And this design here, this is the like a rainbow, like flower one. This will probably be one of the designs. It depends on the company if they can do the screen printing in the multiple colors, on different colors. I'm gonna sneeze.
Deb Pity Mama of Two. Hi, Turtle Family. Happy Thursday. Bless you.
Thank you. Hold on a second. Let me get my. Sanitizer.
Why? You think I'm gonna get sick?
I'm gonna be working on tumblers.
Oh. Well, they get wiped down with alcohol before we ship them anyway.
And everything else, but I just didn't want to be picking up stuff. Thank you.
Kelly Tabor, hey, hey. God bless you.
Thank you.
Debbie Pity Mom of Two, God bless you.
Thank you. I saw that Academic Ferret. I saw that present. You're in there. Let me make sure this isn't too hot still. I think that's still too hot. Can you give me some of that bottled water? We'll just drop some colder water in it. We're gonna get these decals on this cup. It's so cool. We got lots of decals going on tonight. I got a really cute design in that'll be great for Mother's Day. I'll show you guys some updates on some of the other tumblers we've been working on. So we're gonna be putting these water slides on, and I like my water to be warm. You don't want it too hot. It'll start to curl on the edges if it's too hot, which is never good. And then you don't want it cold because it'll take forever to loosen up. But if it's nice and warm, within just a few seconds, your water slides should release and be able to move. So we're gonna put this guy on. He's so cool. Come on, slide for me. And I'm probably gonna have to move him here and there because I want the group line to line up. Oh, it's awesome! Where's my brush? There it is. There's my
brush. Megan, did anybody else get a message from somebody in their last live with their Tumblr order info? Midas614 said I did. I'm not following. What happened?
Yeah, what, did we send an email to somebody wrong?
Michael saying...
Oh, I see. Another creator reached out to them to buy their Tumblr instead of mine. Yeah, I'd be interested to know who that is, because that's kind of like against our little code of artist ethics. If it's a design that I can't make, I will refer you to an artist that does it great. But we shouldn't be taking each other's customers. We all work very differently. The Turtle Family rocks. Can one of you guys send me that username? Like if somebody sent that to you and said, hey, buy my Tumblr instead?
Yeah, because that's uncool. We refer people to other Tumblr makers, and
we
definitely don't want people
help Tumblr makers
stealing
out.
Ours.
I mean, I will help a Tumblr maker out. I get private messages all the time. I'm stuck. What do I do? Or how do I fix this? Whatever. And I will share everything I know with you. But don't try to poach my customers. That's not cool. Yeah, you don't do it with just small business in general, right?
Wow, it sounds like quite a few people got something going on there. So let us know who that user is.
Let's know who that is, because we'll just make it convenient for them not to be able to see these lives in my videos. Okay.
Designed by Light was the name.
Okay. Yeah. Well, if we see them show up,
can
we will definitely take care of it.
Write that down.
Bring what down?
Write it down.
Oh, yeah. Designed by Light.
Yeah, that's totally uncool. Is that not amazing? Now, the next coat of epoxy, you won't even be able to see this little line around it. So awesome!
You've stolen all the pens, I think.
None of them are in there.
What's that, chicken soup?
Did you put that in there? Because I didn't put that in there. Yeah, that's way uncool. That's not cool. I know, I love it. You know what, there's Tumblr makers out there that when they get started, whether it's just out of maybe just ignorance being new to the industry, they'll take another Tumblr maker's photo and say, anybody interested in this, I can make it. Well, that's not cool. We don't do that. We don't take somebody else's Tumblr and advertise it as if we can do it. You need to show your work. If I showed you a Bob Ross painting and then I delivered what I can paint, you would not be happy. And that's what happens in a lot of cases. And so it's just, that's not something, there's just a couple no-nos that we don't do in our industry, and poaching customers is one of them. That's just not.
We got it. Thank you everybody for giving us that information.
Yeah. But I will help you out if you got questions. I'll certainly help you along the way.
It was the person that asked about the wave technique.
Gotcha.
And again, on our lives, if people ask questions, that's what we're here for. We're going to answer them.
Yeah. I'll do a Tumblr tips on it. We'll do it. I'll help you out. I'll show you how to do it. I'll walk you through it. I'll hold your hand. Just don't take my customers. I like my customers.
And we work hard to get you guys.
We do. Oh my God, this is so freaking awesome. I'm sorry, but this is like one of my new favorite Tumblrs.
That is really freaking cool.
We'll do an actual like black line to kind of define it so it's got a nice seam. But that is just so cool. I love that little touch of red. That little just...
Michael said he is awesome.
So cool.
Dusty said, question, the Groot with the background, isn't it too dark?
It looks darker on camera than it does in person. If you wanted to lighten it up, you could, but it's hard to, I guess if you saw it like, and that light there is almost kind of where I see in person. It's a lot, there's a big contrast between the two. But you could, if you wanted to lighten that up, you absolutely could. Or you could do the power wash technique on the other side to kind of make that a full circle. I kind of wanted it to look like Venom was kind of breaking out of there.
So many people are sitting there saying that you do such great work. They can't handle the talent. They're here forever, so don't worry about it. I'm not going anywhere, Jeannie.
Oh, I saw somebody say something about he looked like it was really rough textured. It made me queasy. Oh, yeah, no, he's just, it's an actual just crackle that we did on the live to make it look like bark. It's so cool. And then that's just like a spray wash with two colors.
Billy Crumpton 119 said, I think it looks fantastic.
Thank you. The first one made you wonder. It's up to the owner of the cup. If they want me to pull that decal off real quick and do a power wash, kind of like a white out on that side, I can do it.
No, they're saying that the other person's tumblers were rough looking.
Oh, I gotcha. I'm sorry. See what happens when I go? Spray wash is wild. I love it. There's so many different things that you can do to it to make it look different each time. It's so cool.
Can we add a little more spray wash, like maybe right in there? Or is it too late? Just a question.
I don't understand what you're saying.
Don't worry about
more
it.
Black
I'll
in
ask
there?
You. Yeah, I'll ask you later.
You love it. You're just curious. Okay, cool. All right, so we have a couple more decals. Let me grab some more cups real quick. Let me know if you see Fuser pop on.
I'm Stir Fuser.
Yes. Where is my police badge? Did I put it in there? I did. No, I didn't. Where did I do my police badge?
I saw it printed out.
What? Hold on a sec. I'm just looking for my other decal. We got a zipper we got to put on, so I thought we could actually attach the zipper. But I got to find the badge that I printed out. We may be drying somewhere else. Why is it that I spend all that time getting ready for this, and then it's not here?
I saw it somewhere. I know I saw it.
Usually I stick them right in with that. I got their zipper in there. That might have been the one that was supposed to go to print when the program closed. That's right, we got lots of others. Lots of them. I do have a bottom I have to put on those Gilmore Girls. So we'll do that one real quick. Tap, tap, tap. I hope everybody's staying warm. I hear some power is getting restored, which is good. And I heard they're getting some of the pipes, some of the water in that back. But I know there's still a ton of people still suffering through this, and I just wish there was so much more we could do, and I don't know how to help sometimes. to Pip Mommy, your hubby is a truck driver. Is he safe? Yes. Yes, the turtles. I know, I heard. It was funny because it was right after I got off the live. I saw that and I was like, oh my God. So I did shoot out an email to our turtle conservatory. Turtle conservation. Shot an email out to my contact there.
Michael wants to know if there's a turtle on his yet.
Not yet. No, not yet. Wait a minute. Yes, there is.
Oh, that's right. I remember.
They both have a turtle on them. Do you want me to show you a full 360 view of it and see if you can find it?
I love that smile.
You know what's funny is you will see my genuine reaction on my face, and whether I'm happy, I'm mad, or I'm one of those girls that I don't cry when I'm sad, but when I'm pissed, I will cry like no tomorrow.
True story.
Yeah. But I have a very hard time controlling my facial expressions. Yes, I hope he's safe. So we just put a little Gilmore Girls coffee addict on there, Gilmore Girls addict on the bottom. It's a little coffee stain ring, and I thought that was perfect for the bottom.
Michael said it's up to you if you want to show him do the 360.
Okay, I'll show you one, okay? Passed it. Angry Criers United, right? You see me crying? Don't think it's because I'm sad. You did find it? Holy crap, you got good eyes. I'll save it for you. When you get it, you can do your I found my turtle video. Too funny.
Glorious Design said that's awesome.
Thank you. All right, let's do a, we've got a supernatural going on. You know that beautiful ombre that we did? It's all scuffed up right now because it's been sanded. That's going to go with the supernatural decals.
Azul said that she found it too. Lemon Squeezy said, I cry when I'm angry. Megan Gilly said, I'm pretty sure me crying only out of anger has caused more marriage fights than anything.
I think he kind of picked up on it pretty quickly because...
I just stay quiet.
Well, and for the first couple years of our marriage, he deployed a lot. He was in the Marines. And so when he would come home, he learned very quickly to kind of step into my rhythm instead of me trying to adjust my daily rhythm to fit his schedule. And so he kind of learned very quickly that I'm a crier when I'm pissed. Just, I don't throw shit, but I will cry.
Scrappy Girl 1993, do you put a turtle on all your cups?
I do. Every cup has a turtle on it. Some of them are just on the bottom. Some of them are incorporated in part of the design, but they're always the same shape, and they sometimes they're hidden on the cup. You gotta find them, you gotta search for them.
Academic Ferret said, submitted my what?
Was there a message before that, maybe?
Yeah, did we miss something?
You're a Lucifer customer? Custom, the Lucifer one? We got stuck watching two episodes last night. Couldn't shut it off.
Three.
We watched three yesterday. Holy crap.
Michael, yeah, that's her new drinking cup. She switched it out.
I messed it up. So I couldn't send it to the customer who won it, so I kept it.
Academic Ferret said, submitted my Lucifer custom request. Size and shape is negotiable.
Wonderful.
Yeah, we just finished. Well, we've got two more episodes left in season three.
How do you feel about, like, 3D, like corn sticking out? Just curious. I do actually mess up, cuz. I do. I sure do. You know, I have a saying, though. If you don't have a strip pile, you're not pushing yourself creatively enough. So I absolutely firmly believe. But you can see I was working on this one. I'm gonna mess it up around his hat. It's like boogered up there. And there's a couple touch-up spots that just didn't turn out nice. You love Supernatural? I've got, that's probably something we're gonna have to start to watch at some point. It's, I don't watch a lot of TV, so when Lucifer, we got that,
Our youngest son has watched all the Supernatural, and he's been trying to get us to watch it. But we don't have a lot of time, so we're very picky about the shows that we do watch.
Yep.
Right now, it's pretty much
Yellowstone. Okay.
Yeah, you know, I've been wanting to see that.
Really good.
Yeah.
So that's on the list. And Heartland, my parents watched that. I'm not sure if I'm into the Western. Not Western.
Yeah, but Kevin Costner is such an amazing actor. I would love to watch.
I'm not going to lie. This is really, really pretty.
But right now, the only things that we're really watching are Lucifer, and I'm still trying to get her to start watching season 2 of Mandalorian, but she doesn't want to watch that until she's done with Lucifer. Navy Vet says Kevin Costner plays a heck of a role. You know what? Kevin Costner
either
nails it or he's just horrible for the role. There's kind of no in between.
Are you kidding? Wasn't he in that movie that we watched that one New Year's Eve? It was like 8 hours
No, back to back. He wasn't in that. You're thinking, what was
Lonesome
that?
Lonesome Dove or something.
Lonesome
like that.
Dove. That's not Kevin Costner? No. Ricky Schroeder's in Lonesome Dove.
You watch Thirsty Turtles on Tuesdays and Thursdays, 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Yep. All right, so you guys want to see a sneak peek of the decal that's going on the Easter Tumblr? I'm just kidding.
April Rose said, new to your profile and your lives, loving the vibe.
Awesome. Em Sturpew, we got you. Oh, wait, just wait. Isn't that adorable? I'm just trying to figure out what we want to do on the bottom. April, I got those new glitters I want to, that's what I'm thinking.
April, we're trying to keep it fun and fresh. We've got some new ideas that we're going to start experimenting with here shortly. That I think you guys will really enjoy and will be a lot of fun. Just make sure your liquors are stocked.
Yes. Well, we'll talk about that in a little bit. Because we've always wanted to have a Tipsy Turtles.
Tipsy Turtle Talk?
a Tipsy Turtles Talk. So we're working on that too. Do the glitters? Definitely. Okay, glitter with some eggs. We could do that. We could do a peekaboo like that geode.
Oh, that would be beautiful.
We got an update on that geode too. Go grab that while I show them this one. And this is the, I bought these files because I think these would be great for anybody who wants to get their mama a cup. Okay. And mama, if you're on here, tag your hubby, tag your girlfriend, your wife, whatever, and say this is what you want. Okay. Because these are stinking adorable. I don't know if you get, they're backwards, but. The four different designs.
Blessed Mama.
With the sunflowers. Aren't those cute?
Multiple skin tones. Just totally gorgeous. If you guys haven't seen Jennifer's sunflower tumblers.
Super cute.
They're to die for.
So I think this would be cute for Mother's Day. Aren't those cute?
Susie said, oh my God, I love it.
It's Tipsy Drinks. It's the only thing that's going in your tumbler. Excellent.
April Rose said, I don't know why I like watching cups, but this is great.
So this is my take on a geode, which is very not traditional of the normal geodes. And there's a reason why I don't like those, and I chose this style. But it's also got a little, they wanted leopard print too. So we did this beautiful quote. Hey, Shelby, I saw that. Thank you. I gotta get you those dimensions. So we put this quote on there, hustle until your haters ask if you're hiring, on this gorgeous geode with the leopard print. So you guys have been following along. Hoodie. Thank you. So you guys have been following along on that one, so I thought I'd show you with the quote on it. So that's what I was...
The glitter on that cup is just amazing.
So pretty. So maybe we'll do that kind of glitter with egg shapes. I think that would be really cute. And then we can put like little vinyl lines over them or whatever to separate them out. That would be super cute. That's what we're gonna do. Excellent. I knew I could count on you guys to help me out with that. All right, Fuster. I am gonna be putting a little decal. Oh, that's why. That's the one that shut down when it was printing. It's got her other little decal on it.
Oh.
Yep.
The additional decals you're putting on.
Yep. Okay, well, I gotta get them printed out. But this is where we're at with your cup. So up here is going to have the Hoosier, and then we're going to have Rand Hill Partner Painters and Big Sal's.
Ginger Stewart said good morning.
that would be cute if you got rid of that screensaver on your computer. Go blue. That's cute though. I hope you love it.
Oh my God, no way, is what she said.
Like, it's got dirt. I mean, come on, right? Is that not awesome? But I wanted to get some of your sponsors on there because I noticed on his Facebook that his sponsors have re-upped for 2021. And you guys are just getting back out on the track, or just recently got back out on the track after a pretty gnarly crash.
Accident,
In December, I think. So, see, I was checking out you, girl. I wanted to make sure I got the feel for this.
She said, so awesome. Michael said, so that's awesome.
I just wanted him to have something he would be really proud of because I know he's really proud of his car. You guys are awesome. Thank you for those presents.
Jenny
You're
w
all
going to
get entered into that monthly drawing.
Jenny W. Design says, it's all good fun. We love our rivalry.
So tell me you've checked out the rivalry videos on my page because they're pretty funny.
M. Sturfew said, my husband is in awe.
Oh, yay! First race after wreck will be this spring.
Well, you'll have it before then.
Let me know when it's coming because I'll be thinking of him safe. You have? I couldn't not do that. I mean, you know, but it did go to a good home.
We just wish you guys were a little more competitive because it would be so much more fun. I'm a diehard Ohio State Buckeyes fan. Even if we just won every other one, I would still be happy because all I want is some competition. And unfortunately, you guys haven't been competitive in quite a while.
A little while.
I'm not trying to rag on you guys or give you any type of grief, but
do you know what though? You see the same team come out there and they put their heart on the field, and that.
They do
impressive.
Play hard against the Buckeyes, and that's amazing because very few of the games are blowouts.
And it's we've supported just, them when they were playing. Anybody that's non-Big
Ten. Right, that's not the
Big
Buckeyes.
Ten.
Or not the Buckeyes.
Or not the Buckeyes, yeah. Well, I mean, I do. There's a couple teams that I do like, but yeah. I love the rivalry. I mean, there's nothing that compares. You see flowers!
Miss Brian MUA, Maua.
You cheer for our Big Ten teams too.
I wrote you a message this evening. We'll get to them.
Yep.
I usually check them pretty much every day. I think I was caught up through like 3 p.m. today, maybe a little bit after that.
If it was an email and not through the web form or reply through that, I'm a little bit slower getting to those. But I am trying to get to them. Most of them are coming through the web chat, which is perfect. Because then while I'm working, he's reading through them. And while he's epoxying them, I can go through them. So
Denise, I apologize. Last live, I was calling you Dennis. Dennis Schlacks. It's Denise. I apologize for that. But she just said so pretty.
Yep. So Mulan is going to get her little chair blossoms. did that lighter pink, that brighter pink around the edge, brought in that texture on
Glorious
the
Glorious Design says, I can't get over the beauty of your designs.
Thank you. I really love what I do, and I think that has something to do with it, because every cup that I make, I would want it to be my cup. So if I love it that much, then, you know, I just end up with the ones that I boo-booed up.
Me too. I get the boo-boo cups.
He gets the boo-boo cups too. My kids don't, though. But, so I love my designs. I love what I do. When you love your work and you can put your passion into it, I really think it just makes a difference.
And her facial features are just worth tuning into the live, regardless of how the tumbler turns out.
You're going to make me blush. Come on. Come up with me. Let's lay these beautiful flowers.
That pity mama of two said, be right back on the phone with the hubby. Riding to Texas, right?
Yeah.
Going cross country.
Tell him
or
that we are all thinking of him and tell him to
be safe
and keep warm.
And get a CB.
And thank you.
CB.
If he doesn't have one, yes, get a CB radio. But and tell him thank you. Thank you for what he does. And you too. All right, we're going to lay this to the edge here. We just want to add some of these on.
Oh my God, Kelly Tabor. My favorite cartoon has always been the Jetsons. Ever did a Jetsons cup? No, we have not.
We have not done that.
That would be fun.
Like he's made a bunch of them.
Well, I do the epoxy, so I see every one of them.
He's all defensive. He's a really good epoxier, though. I will tell you, he has learned really fast.
I have to.
Yes, your husband gets the same sentiments too. Yes, anybody who's got a husband or a wife or a partner out there helping out in this and driving through this and delivering supplies and linemen and everybody, please.
Even not during this nasty weather that we're getting, you guys are essential. Those people are essential workers. They keep our country going so that we have food and clothing and everything else. It's so important. We're really finding out who the actual
true essential workers are. Healthcare workers are, it's not our CEOs and
Twilight Creation 788-789. Hey guys.
Hello. Sorry, I get super focused sometimes when I'm laying decals. Otherwise I'll end up all wonky and then I have to blame it on you and not me. So
Miss Brian said he's been driving for 15 years and I'm a stay-at-home mom and it's been hard, but he loves it.
That's pretty cool, though. That's pretty cool. I will tell you, I actually at one point thought maybe that's something I would have considered, because when we were on the volunteer fire department, I had to take the emergency driving test. And 90% of the departments that show up at those, they bring their squad cars because they're smaller and they're easier to maneuver. But not our chief. We took the big ass engine. Of course we did.
42 feet long.
The big ladder truck, the biggest one we have. And we had to run through that driving course, which is the most intense driving course I've ever seen. And I passed that. I got 2 points taken off. And that was it. And that was because I hit a stupid coin, a little cone. It rocked. on the easiest part, straight away. I hit it, I bumped it. But it was amazing to me to have that big engine and that big truck. And I thought, I could probably do this. But then I realized I don't like driving long distance. So that kind of ruined.
I used to drive almost every day from Cleveland to Columbus, which was a 2.5 hour
drive. Loved
and
it.
I loved it. I love driving. I think it's awesome. And it's always something I thought I could possibly do.
Yeah.
But then we rented a moving truck from Ohio to Florida. And the first thing I did was knocked over my neighbor's
stone
mailbox.
Custom made mailbox.
That was like $400. So then I realized that that was not for me.
That we wouldn't be able to afford the insurance.
Megan Gilly said, I feel as a girl trucking would need too much. I gotta pee way too much. right? Yeah, I'd be stopping too because I have a small bladder. I'd be stopping like every hour.
I don't. I can go hours. But I guess anybody who's worked in restaurants probably has learned that. It's really not that healthy. But I can go hours. I can do. I don't mind being a passenger in the car for a few hours. I don't like being on the road. I'd rather fly. If it's going to be that long, I'll fly. This is beautiful.
Yeah, the cherry blossoms are awesome on this cup.
This is gorgeous. I'm just talking away, just doing this, and it is so pretty.
I just want to thank all of you guys because not only are you supporting us, but you're supporting the other people that are in our live, you know, saying how much you appreciate them and what their spouses or significant others do.
Supporting our community.
And that's just awesome. I mean, this little community that we've grown is just, it's amazing.
It's like a little turtle clan. All right, so I'm going to put some of these little sporadic ones that are left on the paper. Just gonna fill in a couple of little spaces just so that we've got. So I'm gonna put a couple up in here just to kind of blossom around. Couple right in here.
Miss Brian said, where did you get your sweater?
I made it. We're trying out some different designs and styles for some apparel that will be hopefully available soon. We are a turtle family, see? I love that. So yeah, we're gonna add a few on here, and this guy is gonna go over to the epoxy. When you see this under epoxy, this alcohol ink texture, when that gets under epoxy.
Oh, it pops. Lemon squeezy said beautiful.
It is, it's just so pretty. So just hang with me for a few minutes while I kind of hand place some of these guys. Need my smaller paper.
M scales 505, Navy vet said, sweet, I was a corpsman for 10 and a half years. Wow.
Wow.
That is one of the probably most underappreciated jobs because when I was in the Marine Corps, we always had a corpsman assigned
to
us.
Thank you for your service.
Yes. We always had a corpsman assigned to us that had to go out and do the exact same things that we were doing with probably, I don't mean this in a negative way, but probably not as much training as we had, but they had to keep up with us. You folks are amazing.
Yeah. You earn the respect out of the Marines, I can tell you that. Alrighty, let's get a couple of these little tweakies in there. Get some of these little itty bitty ones. Oh, it's stuck.
Where did you show them where you're at with that?
Yeah,
I didn't see it because I wasn't looking. I was reading comments.
Okay.
Navy vet was, I was 1/7 Marines out of 29 Palms. I was at Camp Lejeune, even though I was only there for probably, 9 months of my total 4 years?
Yeah.
The rest of the time I was deployed.
Yeah. Yeah, you weren't home a lot. Where did those little ones keep going? There it is. I'm like, where did it go? It's a little tiny one. I want it on there. There it is. There it is. Whoa, scratched it. Okay. These little flowers are so cute. Okay, a couple up here. Add a little frame around that. These little sticks.
Megan said, I just want to hug and thank everybody here for all the things.
Aw, see? I'm telling you, if you're just having a bad day, just jump on my page. I might do some behind the scenes work during the day. I might pop on where I'm gonna set up the camera and I just might be working. Like, I won't be talking to the camera, it's just gonna be set up. And I'm gonna be working, so if you just wonder what's going on in the workshop, you'll see it. You may see me do a dance break. You're likely to see that. I dance in my workshop all the time because I can. Oh my God, that is so pretty. See how just adding a few kind of coming up here and coming down here just frames it a little bit? I think I'm gonna pop a little one right in there. Yep, right there. And let's fit this one here. Oh, so cute. There we go. So we're just gonna work on this side. Braxton might be joining us shortly. He just woke up. We have, this is kind of funny. We have a cat tree in the corner, and then I've got shelves back there. It has all of my blank stock on it, all my tumblers. And on one of the shelves, it's reserved for, hi bud, this is warm water. Do you want cold water? Why, Dad will get you some cold water, okay? So on his shelf, he has a really big wicker basket, and it's about this tall. And then he's got blankets in there. We used to have a heating pad in there, but he doesn't get it this year. But his blankets are in there. And so he was laying in there, and Mr. Turtle said the one day, are you in your casket instead of basket? And I lost it. So now we call it the catskit. He sleeps in his catskit. You got it. Tuesdays and Thursdays, 9 p.m. Eastern. And then Saturdays, we're going to start shooting for around 8 o'clock. But it's going to be a kind of a different vibe, I think. I think it'll be fun. I think it'll be really fun. I didn't tell him yet. I didn't give him any details.
Don't need to.
I want to bring this.
Denise said my cat is sleeping in my laundry basket right now.
Well, you got a catskit too.
It's probably because the laundry's warm. Look at
or comfy. Hi, bud.
Pretty soon you guys aren't going to be able to see anything.
Hi. Did you just wake up from your nap? Huh? You were in your cat coma after your yummies, huh? You just woke up.
Megan said, drunken tumbler Saturday.
It's probably going to be something around that. Yeah, I think we're just going to have Tipsy Turtle Saturdays, and we're just going to have some fun and make a beverage.
Okay, so the academic ferret said one of my ferrets is sleeping in my cheese ball jar, LOL. And that only makes sense seeing that your name is Academic Ferret.
Right.
We had two ferrets.
We had two ferrets.
A long time ago.
Mm-hmm. We did. Skylar and Luna. And our youngest couldn't say their names because he was like 18 months old. And so we called them Kai Kai and Luna. So that's what we call them, Kai Kai and Luna. And somehow those little shits got out of their cage and got into the vent. And we heard little pitter-pattering of feet in the ceiling above us. And we're like, what the heck? So Mr. Turtle had to cut a hole in where the light is. He had to pull it and cut a hole in it to get the ferrets down. Somehow they got into that. Alcohol plus you typing might be bad, LOL. You have 7 rescues. Aww. Please do make it tequila or Jameson. So, all right, we can talk about what our idea is, I guess. So what we were going to do, we have a really good friend of ours who is really creative, and she loves to just kind of brainstorm with us on fun stuff to do. And so we were talking about our lives, and that we often, you know, have make a drink and sit here and make cups. And I'm actually working, which is really cool. So both sides are wrapped around. This is going to epoxy. This is beautiful. It really is pretty. I think I might stick a couple down there. And so we decided that we might do, I gotta pull this one off yet, shit. That we would do a kind of a drink themed evening where while we were having a drink, we would make it on like the recipe and give you guys the recipe. And while we make that drink, we'll make a tumbler for it to be drunk out of. And then that tumbler may become a giveaway tumbler.
With the recipe on the tumbler.
With the recipe on the tumbler. I think it might be kind of fun. Might be kind of fun.
Lemon Squeezy says sounds like a deal, but she was replying to Megan Gilly. Mida614 says I'm in. Azul said, oh, that's a cool idea. Lemon Squeezy loved the idea.
Right? I think our first one is going to be coffee related because it's so stinking cold. I'm all for a little bit of coffee.
M Scale says, ooh, that would be fun. Debbie Pity Mama of Two said that would be cool.
Right? You guys could kind of hang out with us. You can make a drink with us if you want. Maybe we'll like pre-release the recipe.
Or tell you at least what liquors you need to have.
Or something like that. Maybe we'll do a, hey, don't forget, on this week's live, Saturday's Tipsy Turtle Talk. And then you guys can make it along with us.
God is good always, 16 says, love that idea. Denise says, I still drink iced coffee in this frigid weather.
You know what? I do like my ice drinks. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, but man, when it gets like that blister cold out, I'm all for a hot beverage. All for it.
Navy Vet says that's a really cool idea. It would definitely get people to watch more. Deb Pity Mama of Two said Captain Morgan orange twist with orange soda.
Okay. Bring that in there. Let me get a smaller branch. A little bit smaller branch.
Midas614 said, love my coffee, 3 pots a day.
Me too. I mean, you don't have to make the drink and drink with us. We're not saying you have to. We're just saying we're going to be drinking. So, how is that different from any other Tuesday and Thursday live? I don't know.
Other than we're providing you with a recipe now of what we may or may not be drinking. Navy Vet said, so where do you guys live at now?
Charlotte, North Carolina.
Deb Pity Mama of Two says, but they no longer make it. What don't they make anymore?
They don't make the
Everglow. The fluorescent green liquor.
Gotcha. That would be fun, though. Back in the day, I was a bartender. There, we just did a little kind of little something on the bottom to kind of bring that decorative edge in. I'm gonna put another one on my hair.
Michael says, my wife and I drink pinion coffee. It's amazing. Mm. Academic Ferret, I have an ultra caffeinated coffee. When I drink it, I see sounds.
You know, I am one of those people that do see color numbers.
Sweet and Sassy 785 NCA. I'm in Fort Bragg.
Awesome.
Dusty said, don't forget the turtle.
Oh, no, it'll have a turtle on there. There we go. It's going to epoxy. Beautiful. That is gorgeous. Gorgeous. Alrighty. What's next? We covered those. Let's see how the water is, because I let it go. We got more decals. It's still pretty warm. Mm. So let's do, we're going to do a St. Patrick's Day tumbler. We're going to do a bottom wrap around the bottom of it. Did you set up an epoxy bath?
No, not yet.
Because we'll need that for this one. So this is going to be this one right here. Yeah. This one's going to be a half wrap around the bottom. And this guy on the top. And we're not doing any glitter on the base, but we are going to do glitter above it. So the whole thing is going to kind of have a glitter sparkle to it. And this will be one of our St. Patrick's Day gnome designs that'll be available. Super cute. So we've got the two different St. Patty's Day gnomes. We've got the one that's going to be going on our leopard print, which we're going to be doing here shortly. And then this guy who is going on this with this wrap. So I couldn't decide on just one. Because I love gnomes. I'm going to leave that edge on just in case I need a little bit. I know, I do too. Well, I am, I've got Irish in me, and so does Mr. Turtle. So we do a lot of Irish fun stuff. We used to go have fun downtown for St. Patrick's Day, but, you know, COVID. You were the lucky one.
Yeah, last year we were supposed to be in Cleveland for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah. Yeah, we were. Are we coming up here? We are. All right, we're almost ready. I'm gonna wrap this guy around. There we go.
God is always good, says love your shirt.
Thank you. Did that just pull?
Megan said, what y'all wearing for the 1 year anniversary for flattening the curve? Ooh, gonna have to think about that one.
Something bigger than we wore last year. I can tell you that.
Lemon Squeezy, I've always gone out St. Patty's Day except for last year and this year. Yeah, we're there with you.
Yeah, last year we were supposed to go up with his whole family. I mean, his whole side of the family is very Irish. And they do the whole St. Patty's Day all day long, downtown Cleveland. Amazing. And we were finally going to be able to make it home to go do that. And then COVID. So that was kind of a little bit of a bummer.
Yeah. I come from a very large family as far as my aunts and uncles are concerned, 11 different aunts and uncles, and almost every family has a firefighter in it, every one of them.
Yeah, very, 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 very fun family. They'll cheat in the game of cards, though. Don't let them tell you they won't.
Bless Mama said, hey.
Hello.
Lemon Squeezy said, Megan Gilly to Lemon Squeezy said, I'll have some Jameson for you this year.
There you go. Whoops.
Lemon Squeezy says, I have a bottle waiting when I can drink it again. Navy Vet says, I drink some apple pie moonshine for you.
Ooh.
Ooh, that's some good stuff right there.
I'll pull my other side. It's sliding up on me. This should be almost completely seamless if I can get it on there, right? It's going to cooperate with me tonight.
Lemon Squeezy said, love apple pie moonshine.
Mm.
If you guys haven't tried it, most of the moonshine places also make a Java moonshine. Oh my God. That stuff is amazing.
Java Mountain moonshine. Tastes like iced coffee liqueur and yum.
And yum. Mm.
Just yum. I just completely stripped that whole thing off, and I'm just like, not even showing you guys what the hell I'm doing. I'm sorry. I'm a terrible host.
Sweet and Sassy says we have a long line of firefighters in her family as well. Me, my brother, my father, my grandfather. Yep, that's kind of how we are on the green side, too. It goes back generations.
Sure
Mr.
does.
Turtle. Then we might be related. My family lives in Cleveland, and a lot of them are firefighters. We may be related.
Yes, we could be. If not, I bet we've been at either the same bar, the same funeral, or the same wedding.
Probably. Because our weddings are not small.
Neither are the funerals.
Neither are the funerals, unfortunately.
Big family. Alright, so I got a little bit of overlap I'm going to cut off, but I wanted to get my Argyle pattern to, keep pulling that section, I don't want to do that. Just working out my little wrinkles, I got some pulls on this.
Glorious Designs.
I need another tumbler.
Ooh, the shine, my favorite is strawberry lemonade.
Ooh, that sounds yummy. Alright, I'm going to end up pulling this off, but I just want you guys to see what it looks like. I'm not happy with some of these little paint pieces that came out, I didn't get a good enough spray on it, so I'm gonna pull that off. But I just want you guys to see what it's gonna look like. This guy is gonna go up here on that, and then it's gonna have, I'm gonna put a gold metallic gold tiny pinstripe, and I might even pinstripe some of the argyle with that tiny gold. Really tiny little thin gold. But that's what he's gonna look like. But we're gonna scrap this and redo it because it just didn't, eh. And I don't want another tumbler that's boogered up. I want a nice one.
Michael said,
I knew it's coming soon.
Gonna be amazing. Mida 614, I have 26 siblings, so anything is possible.
Wow. You do have a big family. I have two older brothers.
Megan said, can we hear how one could have 26 siblings? They were very committed.
Are there multiples? Are there a lot of multiples? I'm incredibly curious, too.
26 is a lot.
All right, let's get our Marvin on. This guy's going on his, and I can clean this up. So, we did the alcohol inks on that live.
Sister wives.
I did a blast of a bright green and then a white over it. And we're gonna put him on, and then I'm gonna take some acetone and bring this down to just look like a glow around Marvin. Okay.
Dusty said, my dad is one of 14. Academic Ferret said, forget the Duggars. You got them beat.
You're an only child with 7 kids.
Wow. Mm. God bless you. Yes. 3 was enough for us.
Yes. Marvin the Martian is awesome. Isn't he cool? He's pretty cool. We're going to put him on here. Not ready yet. Getting a little cool.
Yeah, it needs to be warmer.
So my water's getting a little colder, so it's taking a little longer for my decal. 21 is your oldest and 2 is your youngest.
Oh my lord.
Bless your heart. 2 part-time kids is enough.
My mom had a big heart and she can foster kids when one up for adoption. That's awesome. And they had. Oh yeah, that makes sense.
That's awesome. That's way cool.
That is awesome.
I've had 2 foster sisters. Five girls and 2 boys. That's a lot of proms. Whew. Let's hope they're virtual.
Let me go heat this up.
Yeah, because he's not pulling off.
No, he needs to suck.
So he's gonna have to sit. And that guy. We're gonna cut 2 of them. We're gonna grab some more water because that one didn't work real well. That was way more uplifting than I expected. I know, you guys are amazing people. Look at the kind of folks that come in and hang out with us. You guys are awesome people. Siblings she would adopt all the, why not, right? Big heart. Very special person. Aw, thank you so much for those hearts. I appreciate it. You'll get entered into to win our monthly drawing. Any gifters go in and we're gonna do a monthly drawing. All right, so while we're waiting for that, I can show you guys a couple things. We've got the Lafayette Hydro Dips that we did, the Louisiana. I can show you those. And I've got the first layer of, here's one of those Hydro Dips we did. Gorgeous. That's gonna be out in a Tumblr Tips video because I forgot to seal that one and we had to sand it down and re-epoxy it. All your decals are printed. They're actually getting their first round of epoxy over the glitter, and decals will go on and then epoxy and then they'll be ready. You guys saw us put those on or reveal those. So we got a coat of epoxy on there so it's nice and shiny now. So he's gonna get sanded and another coat of epoxy and he'll be ready to go. And this was the one we were working. You guys might have saw the video for it. For Desert Road Decals, she does stickers. So we put a little glitter shimmer. You guys saw me hydro dip this one, or spray wash it. Super cute. Hey from Florida. You love all my cups, thank you. Especially the turtle ones. Those are my favorites too. I have so many favorites though. All right, we got some water, so let's go ahead and decal. I got the other two Louisiana ones over there. I'll pull out and show you. Okay, let's, we were doing St. Patrick's Day. Where did he go? So you guys, we worked on this ombre, and then we did the leopard spots. It's now got a flood coat on it. Seems so dark. It's not that dark. So we're gonna put our decal on him. Now, the handle cup. Do you wanna look at the decal, or should the decal be on the outside? What do you guys think? Should it be out here while I'm drinking? Or do you wanna see it when you're drinking? If you're right-handed, if you're left-handed, what do you guys think? Facing the drinker or outside? Outside?
Outside. Show it when you're drinking.
Yep, I think so too. So we're gonna put them on there. We're gonna go with a right-handed cup person.
Outside. So yeah, I would say that everybody agrees it should be on the outside.
We'll put it on the outside. So people share your love. That's a great idea. See, there you go. Everybody can be happy. I like looking at mine. What'll probably end up happening is I'll probably print another one and put it on the other side. So it'll have two decals just so that the drinker can see it and the people outside there can see it. It's probably what I'll end up doing. There we go. Oh, he's so cute. Oh, he's so cute. I love these little gnomes. They're adorbs.
Adorbs.
They're adorbs. Take those really stuck
together. Elena said, LOL, that'll be great too. Twilight Sky Creations. I like looking at mine, and then when I'm not drinking, I put it so I can see.
So others see can see it, others. See? You just...
Yep.
How many cups do I have with slight imperfections? Well, every cup is handmade. So to be honest with you, in my opinion, they all have slight imperfections. I don't think I've been able to achieve a perfect, perfect cup yet.
Deb Pity Mama of Two, what size is that cup?
This is a 20 ounce with handle. The 20 ounce skinny, and the handle's up, so it'll actually fit in your cup holders, which is why I like these. I think I'm gonna, you're right, I could put a little saying on the other side.
Michael said, no, they have personality, not imperfections.
There you go, just little sprinkles of love. But yeah, I mean, it's, I don't know if anybody's able to achieve a perfect tumbler, but. I love that. That is so cute. Super cute. All right, another one down. All right. We're gonna do a murder show. Oh, there it is. I found it. The badge and the Hoosier that I wanted to put on. It was with my other cup. I knew I printed it. Thought I sprained it. Ah, hold on guys, we're gonna do this other cup real quick.
Azul said, so cute, love the hand-painted leopard.
Where did you let these cups go?
Right here.
There she is. We're gonna put the police badge on.
Dusty said is making a cup with a handle a pain.
It is a little bit. I mean, it's a little bit more difficult to work with when you're epoxying it, to make sure you get the coverage on it, and get the right glitter, you know, coverage. But they're really cool when they're done.
Sweet and Sassy said, perfect for the customer.
I hope so. I mean, like I said, I've got almost a crippling level of perfectionism.
D-Lin-A said, is this one mine?
Which one's yours? What's the badge number on it?
Is it the 103? You have to let me know if that's your, the badge number on is 103.
Yep.
It is. Oh, we're going to be putting your zipper on too. I'll show you in just a second.
Yeah, and thank you for getting us a better picture of the badge, because the quality of the picture is really very, very important.
It can affect the quality of the tumbler, but this one turned out amazing. It's really cool. Super, super cool. So we're gonna get ready to do your zipper. Can you grab me? Oh, I got it. Alexa, next please.
That was cute that you said, Alexa, next, please. Like, she cares.
Right? Like, she's like, aw, thanks, Jen. Aw, look, I see a Canyon Green O.O. in here.
Buddy, what's up?
That's my baby. He's like, out, dropped it, scroll on.
Yep, he left.
That's the baby bird.
Do you put the full stripe and then cut the V?
I do. I stripe the whole thing. And then because I like to put it on the opposite side, the badge with the zipper, I like to put it on the opposite side of the stars in the center.
Canyon Green OO said, hey Ma, how's the live going?
It's going well, honey. Thank you for asking. Tom, I just said that.
Your FBI agent just knows you're polite now, is what she was trying to
say. Right? Exactly. They're like, oh, at least she'll, you know, she'll slam the door in her face when I invade their house. So when you're doing a zipper, these are real zippers. I try to match them to the tumblers. So these police tumblers and my American flags usually get a silver with a black, black base around the tumbler or around the zipper. So I'm just cutting the edge off the fabric off the zipper.
Deb Pity Mama of Two said, Tom, I just said the same thing to myself out loud, meaning how polite you are to Alexa. You should hear me talk to her. It's not nice.
Well, sometimes she doesn't listen, and then I have to get kind of rude with her. But I don't like
that. Mida 614, with the zipper, is there a special way you need to clean the cup?
No, we're gonna attach it with E6000. You just want to be super careful that you don't goop it outside of that, because you don't want E6000 on your epoxy. It's really difficult to get off at that point.
But just like the rest of the cup, it's gonna have epoxy over the zipper. So if you just follow our cleaning instructions that we include with every one of our tumblers, you'll be fine with the zipper.
Yep, it's not a raw zipper on top. It'll be covered and protected under epoxy.
Megan Gilly, I can't sober type. Saturdays are going to be fun, especially now that I'm drinking for two.
Oh, right? Your hubby's like, that's not fair. he'll get to catch up maybe when he gets home and gets a break, I hope. Ooh. So when you're doing this, you want to, I'm sorry, I did that off camera, sorry. You want to just, if there's any little stringies, you want to pull those off, and then we are going to light the edges up to clean them up. Try to get as much of it trimmed down, but the lighter helps kind of shrink up those, it's just real quick, and it gets rid of these strings. You just don't want to have it look uneven. So you're just kind of melting away so that it's just a nice even zipper.
Azul's 1972, can you use the Dawn Power Wash to clean a completed cup?
Yeah, you can use Dawn soap to clean your cup. That's how we wash ours out. I don't soak mine or put them in the dishwasher. You don't want to do that. But I just throw some on my sponge and scrub it with a scrubby, like a scrub daddy, inside and out with Dawn dish soap. You're good. You're good. Did I misunderstand that or no?
No, I think you got it right.
Yeah, just a really good cleaning. So I'm just kind of sealing away. If you guys have ever done this with frayed edges of your string before. So all we're doing is we're just kind of getting those frayed edges. We don't want it to peel or, you know, get little edgies on there when we're epoxying.
Or if you're in a military family, those are usually called rappelling ropes.
There you go.
Rappelling strings, you get rid of those.
There we go. So, and it still works once it's all cut. Still goes up and down.
Mida 614, can't wait until I get my taxes back. I'm ordering a tumbler.
Awesome. So we just want to measure out, before we glue anything, we want to measure out where the zipper is going to be, where the main part of the zipper.
D-Lanay said, where did you get the idea for the zipper initially?
I probably saw somebody who had made a tumbler with a zipper on it. I certainly didn't come up with the idea for sure. It's just a tumbler I've done a lot of. But I probably saw somebody. It's hard to say. I mean, the flight one with the extra zippers, I've never seen anybody use more than one, but who knows? I don't think anybody actually creates anything new anymore. Everybody's got a take on something. So I just want to make sure that my zipper is going to go down straight. And then I'll be clipping off the edge, the top edge off the top of the cup here, but I just want to make sure that I get a nice V shape.
Can you push it back a little bit?
I'm going to tip down so they see
or
this part.
Push this back.
Nope, we're good. And I'll be able to turn this so they can actually see it towards them. They can see it. Okay, and let's try this. You guys see that a little bit there? And I'm just gonna take my E6000 and I'm gonna glue it on.
Michael said, what's your opinion on a zipper for the firefighter tumbler that we talked about? Most of the turnout coats that we've done in the past have had a zipper on them, but they don't have to have a zipper on them.
That's not what he's talking about. He's talking about the New York firefighter scene.
Oh, for that scene.
That was designed as a full wrap. I might be able to condense it to put a zipper in. It might cramp the design. I'd have to think about that and let me kind of picture it for a minute. So when I do my zippers, I start at the zipper part and I just start I do the bottom first. A lot of times I'll just let them dry with the bottom first. And just lay it down. Like I said, you want to be real careful because you don't want to smear that E6000 everywhere. You want to try to get down as straight as possible. You don't want it hanging over the bottom either.
Michael said a zipper over the 343 emblem is what I see in my mind, but just an
That's
idea.
What I'm wondering. If I took that part of the image, because I did layer it, I could take that part of the image actually out and shorten up that wrap a little bit, and it would have that black smoky blend into the zipper, and we could put that badge, that 343, up in the zipper. That I could do. That would be pretty cool. So So we're just letting this kind of sit on there, making sure it's not sliding down the cup on me while it's at an angle. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually glue down the zipper because we don't want that flying down when we got epoxy on it.
Michael says I like it.
We could do that. Just you'd have send shoot me a message if you want to make that change to your design. Just so I don't forget and get, you know, halfway into that cup and be like, oh, I forgot. Because I do have a really, really bad memory. And E6000 doesn't take too long to dry, but I like to let it sit. Like I said, I like it to not move around too much. Because if I start moving this, I don't want that to get all sideways. You still need an invoice for that one. Okay, got you. Mr. Turtle, you got that? Can you write that on that side? Here's my paper I was doing for my decals. Put that with the other one. Thank you. Otherwise, I'll forget. I'm sorry. I thought we shot that out already to you. I'm sorry. Mr. Turtle dropped the ball again.
Mr. Turtle is pretty good at that. I got a lot to keep up with.
You're good. We're not sliding down, are we? No. It's almost not going to move too much more. So I'm going to go ahead and drop a dollop on here. Now, I don't like to do too many coats of epoxy over a zipper. I like to do one, maybe two, thin coats. I want to make sure that sets straight on your zipper. And there's just a little bead of E6000 there to hold it down. But the epoxy will cover it, but you don't want a super thick. I usually put two thin coats. You don't want a super thick coat over that because then your cup just gets real bulky. You're late to our live. Don't worry about it. We just put this decal on, this really cool police badge, and we're applying the zipper now. And TikTok lets us record these. So I've uploaded. Did I upload the last one?
Not yet.
Shoot, I forgot that. I was trying to edit the ending. I had it running longer. But we're uploading those to the YouTube channel, so you'll be able to replay the lives. So if you're not following my YouTube, go follow me on YouTube.
A lot of people are saying they thought something was a decal. I think they're talking about the zipper. They didn't realize the zipper was
real.
No,
it's a real zipper. Yeah, it's a real zipper. You will see some tumblers that people have done sublimations on, and it's part of the image. But I like the real deal. So we're gonna glue, once this dries up a little bit more, we're gonna glue the tops and then snip it off so it's just below the edge.
Daza Kid says, because I was wondering how to do the zippers.
That's how I do them. They're real zippers. Just adds a little kind of authenticity to it. It's just different. You know, when you get kind of a 3D element to the cup, it's kind of cool. It's not so bulky that you feel weird holding the cup, but it's definitely, some people don't like the texture of it over a zipper.
D. Lene said, I'm excited. Dusty, what else besides the turtle will go on that? Do you put the zipper on at the end?
Yep, so the zipper is going to go on, and then the turtle will go on, and then it's going to get a coat of epoxy, and then a nice sand, and a coat of epoxy. And then it'll be on the cure table, and then it'll get ready to ship. It'll go to its photo shoot, and then it will get shipped out.
Ida 614, I just love it. The zipper just gives it that extra wow factor.
I think so too. I think it's way cool.
Jessica Bryson 6, I need a cup like this.
Isn't it awesome? I love these. I think they're classy, respectful.
And they still honorable. Fit in your coffee cup.
And they still fit in your cup holder in your car.
In your cup holder in your car.
I can move on you now.
Dusty says, do you photo shoot all cups?
I do. I will tell you there was like two tumblers I forgot to take pictures of and I wasn't happy about it because they were freaking amazing. I did get a video of them. I did not get pictures of them. But usually they go to a photo shoot and then a quick video shoot. Then they may go to the TikTok stage to get a special TikTok video made. Cure table, clean, out the door.
Jessica Bryson 6, how do we order?
You can go right on my website, thirstyturtletumblers.com, and there is a custom request form on there. You can just fill that out. Let me know what you're looking for. Your favorite is still the Aquanet. It's pretty cool. Nostalgia, I mean, come on. I like that 80s tumbler was pretty cool too. That roller skating one was pretty cool. Stevie Nicks was awesome though. See, I love all my tumblers, I can't decide.
Virgif Clark, I hope I said that right. Virgif Clark, I love it.
Turn that a little bit.
Beamer 712, you are so talented, love them, but my fave is still the Aquanet.
That one is super cute. Like I said, nostalgic tumblers, you can't go wrong with those. They just kind of bring a smile to your face. I'm gonna go ahead and clean up a little bit of that glue. Like I said, you don't want to have it too thick with the glue. And I'm gonna do one side at a time. You don't want to rush your zippers. If you try to do them too fast, I mean, Mr. Turtle's really good at doing it, and then he'll tape them down for me because he's done a lot of my zippers for me. They take a lot of patience to look nice. And so don't rush your tumbler. You spent all that time making this awesome tumbler. Don't rush the zipper. CarMax.
Denise said.
She's pulling that up to actually put the decal for.
Didn't you do the CarMax tumbler?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, we did one of those, and we
got
also
Burt's
have another
Bees, a chapstick,
order for another CarMax
a
one.
A Brazilian Kiss lips chapstick. Those were all the chapstick ones I think I did.
Jessica Bryson 6 said, heading there now, thank you.
Awesome.
Beamer 712, oh, nope, that was the Aquanet, said, love the Aquanet.
All right, I'm gonna let this one sit off to the side for a minute and dry while we go on to another, keep it tipped a little bit, I don't want that to move. We'll go on to another decal.
Do you want this? Yeah, you keep that.
How are you gonna set that? You're gonna put it on a foam?
Yep.
You're smart, Mr. Turtle.
I know.
You're so smart. All right. Okay. We got another tumbler we're gonna put. This is a murder show tumbler. We're gonna put a decal on real quick. And then some blood stains and a bloody handprint will do. I'm not gonna do that tonight.
Denise said I may need to request my CarMax one for a friend.
Awesome.
Randar 3882. A gem tumbler would be amazing, or rainbow bright, or strawberry shortcake. We did something with some of those, didn't we?
Well,
80s
stuff. I did an 80s theme, and then I think I did. I had Rainbow Bright on there. I can't remember what all was on that one.
Here's a great question. Debbie Pity Mama of 2. How did you come up with your name, Thirsty Turtle?
I love sea turtles and I love the beach. The beach is my happy place. And I'm also very passionate about endangered species animals. And when I realized that out of the 7 species of sea turtles, 6 of them are on the endangered species list, one of them is really close to being, it's on the watch list. I bought one of those little things and I followed my turtle around the tip of Florida and swimming all around. And I decided at that point I wanted to be able to kind of help out and do something that I really love to do. And so Thirsty Turtles came about, and that's why we our Turtle Cups help out the Turtle Conservatory.
Lemon Squeezy said a Gilligan's Island tumbler.
Haven't made one of those.
Mirandar 3882, yes, gem in the holograms.
That'd be pretty cool. There's, you know, you get so many great ideas for tumblers, and you know, I love when you guys get on here and come up with these ideas, because that's, I got custom cups to make, and every time it's a new idea and it's a cool idea and I love it.
Brown
I'm not
Ice,
doing the same ones over and over and over again.
Brown Eyes 6518 80s has Rainbow Bright, Strawberry Shortcake, Barbie, and more.
Yes, that'd be kind of cool. I did
Smurfs,
a couple similar
we
to
haven't
that,
done Smurfs. That's an amazing 80s.
Did you do a Bratz?
Bratz is more than like 90s.
I didn't do it. Yeah. Yeah, this one's gonna have some blood stains on it, and then we're gonna put a bloody handprint on it.
If someone sent you a picture of their pets, can you do decals for a tumbler with them?
I don't typically work with photographs. Images, I can work with, but photos, like actual photographs, it's not my jam. I can give you the name of a tumbler artist that's much better at photo tumblers than me. I hit a creative block on those sometimes, and they just, to me, they always look like I just stuck a picture on a tumbler, and I don't want to deliver that as a product, if that makes sense.
Sweet and Sassy 785. I love sea turtles as well. Sea turtles, everything around my house.
Blood stains are red. Ultraviolet lights are blue. I've watched enough murder shows. They'll never find you. And then it'll have some blood splatter around it. And a bloody handprint. And I think maybe even a little crime scene tape.
Megan Gilly says, Turtle Sun 1, 2, or 3? Because Debbie Pity Mama of Two said, is that a turtle son?
Are you, what?
I don't know. I might have missed something.
Maybe we missed a comment. I'm sorry. We were talking about the baby we were talking about. That is a baby turtle. My baby bird. That's what I call him. He's the youngest of the turtle family. He's off doing his thing at ECU. Oh, that's my nephew.
Okay. They were asking about Keegan.
They're like, we heard another voice. That's my nephew. He's from Ohio, and he's here going to college. And so he gets to hang and chill out with us when he's not in class. Canyon says, I'm the baby turtle here.
Yeah, Canyon is the baby turtle. He's our baby turtle, our last turtle.
This is the last one.
Woo. Deputy Mama of Two said, hi, nephew.
Hello.
Hello.
Nephew turtle.
Candy Green OO. Hi, baby. From Debbie Pity Mama of Two.
Yeah, he's the baby. He's not a baby.
He's not a baby. He's 21. But he's still our baby. And we miss him dearly.
I know. He's gonna have to FaceTime your mom. To miss your face. I'm just cutting out some blood splatter because we're gonna put a little bit of blood splatter in this cup.
Rob Ann Davis said, save the turtles, yes.
So I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I don't send out any of the plastic straws with your tumblers. Plastic's not great for the ocean. And the turtles certainly don't like them. But we have metal straws that we are going to be carrying for our 20 ounces that have their own, they're individually wrapped and have the individual own cleaner. It's the straws like I'm using. They're stainless steel. So much better for the environment, so much better for the turtles. So that is something that we're going to be bringing into
our
subscription boxes and have available for you guys because, you know, if somebody can figure out some great things to do with recycled straws, I've got 1,000 of them.
Audrey Bama said, hey, hey.
Is that your nice way of telling me to order some metal straws?
M. Scale said, I was just thinking that. Lemon squeezy metal straws all the way.
Right. I mean, it's... I can't be a turtle company and save the turtles and then send you a plastic straw. We use a lot of recycled materials. We try to do everything we can to kind of reduce our carbon footprint and care for the turtles. We try to recycle as much as we can. We try to reuse. It wouldn't be very nice of me as a business owner. Again, it wouldn't be very genuine. Wouldn't be very genuine if I sent out a bunch of plastic straws with my turtle tumblers. So,
I think it makes you drink too.
I do too. And you know what? I thought at first I wasn't going to like drinking a hot beverage out of it, but it's not like it doesn't get hot. The straw doesn't get hot. So, you only use reusable straws. See, there you go. What is the material I'm applying to this cup? This is a water slide decal. I'm going to be releasing a Tumblr tips on it, a start to finish. I've got a printed sheet. I'm going to show you exactly how I seal them. And I'll be launching it probably tomorrow. I'll put that one out.
Megan said, I'm going grocery shopping tomorrow. I'm now going to have to buy some metal straws.
See, you even cut the plastic. See, I do the same thing. Anytime you buy those plastic thingies, right? Did you know that there's a company out there that's actually replacing those with stuff that when it hits the ocean water, it actually turns into food? Like fish food? I think that's pretty cool. Trying to work out a deal with them with some packaging materials, but I haven't gotten a response yet.
Megan, reach out to us, and if you need metal straws,
we got you, girl.
We got you.
My VIPs just have to have a little bit of patience. Y'all have tumblers coming. So we're just going to add a couple more, and then I'm going to do a layer of epoxy, and then we'll actually add a couple more. I want to kind of get that dimension on the blood splatter. I don't want it to just look like a flat white cup. So I'm going to put a couple more splatters on the other side, and then we're going to epoxy it, and then we'll do some more blood splatter.
Sweet and Sassy 785. Yes, I love that idea. Deb Pity Mama of Two. I have reusable plastic straws. Does that help? Of course it does.
Absolutely.
We're not telling you that you have to switch to a metal straw, but anytime you have the ability to reuse the plastic that you're using.
That you're using. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Michael said, my wife ordered silicone straws.
It's a great idea.
They seem to work very well.
That's a great idea. Silicone straws are great. It should have a chalk outline of the body.
That would be interesting.
I just got to put a bloody handprint. My bloody handprint. Just waiting for Mr. Turtle to piss me off enough. No, I'm just kidding. I was just going to put...
That shouldn't take long.
You're so funny. That's a really cute idea. I might look into that. That would actually be kind of cute. You have a plain Yeti cup you can send to decorate. Most Yeti cups come with a powder coating on them, and I'm not going to take your really expensive tumbler and destroy your powder coating on it so that I can make you a tumbler. I will tell you that the quality of the tumblers that I do use is within minutes of the quality of a Yeti tumbler. And not to mention the fact that a lot of times Yetis, people decorate them, and it covers the Yeti logo on it anyways. So nobody really knows that it's a Yeti. You're right, they do. This the company that I got them from, that's one of the things I asked, was make sure that they weren't super sharp on them. And I was really pleased. We did a lot of testing before we decided on who we were gonna use to get those from. I was really, really, it's not easy to find them individually wrapped with an actual cleaner. They come in a package with its own cleaner. So I'm really happy with the company that we found. So we're just gonna put a couple more blood splatters on here. I like the idea of the chalk outline though. That's kind of cool. I kind of like that. That would be an interesting take on it. I like it.
Miranda R3882, the metal straws tend to be sharp and can be hazardous to smoke.
I already read that one out, yeah. I told them we went through our testing of them to make sure that none of them were
None of them are sharp. But
I mean, plastic straws for kids.
Not good anyway.
I mean, kids are going to use whatever their sippy cup or their straw, like a plastic straw that fits in their tumbler anyways. The metal isn't much different to me. That's why I kind of like them. These. They're not like a real bulky. They're kind of a thinner metal. Are the kids' cups different? They are, the 15-ounce ones are exactly like the 20-ounce skinnies. They're just 15 ounces. They're a little bit smaller. And then the duo cups have the sippy lid and a screw-on lid that comes with the straw.
Sweet and Sassy 785 said yellow crime tape on the cup.
That's what I'm thinking, was yellow crime tape. For the kids though, if you're concerned that they're gonna drop it and crack that epoxy on the bottom, on your request, you can have me, I can tape off And leave a silver bottom on the tumbler. The worst that'll happen if they drop it is it'll get dented, but it won't break any, it crack epoxy. Because most of the time if they fall, they're gonna hit this corner. Edge.
Michael said how much for the duo cups?
The duo, I think those were 35. Yeah, I think they start at 35 on the design. Because they have that sippy cup lid and then they have the screw on lid. You can grab one of those. Where's that box at? We moved them all. So I think they're the top. Are those up on top right there? To the left of the 30-ounce screw? No, those are the 30-ounce straights.
No, I think they're down here.
Yeah. When I cleaned the garage, I put my tumblers in size order and stuff, and I can't remember right now. Well, we might not have see if we can grab. No, I know we have duos.
We have. Oh, here it is.
Hold on. Here we go. We'll show you what they look like. So they've got a sippy lid. And just a little meat cup. Little screw on plastic lid. What's nice about this plastic lid is the actual slide lid is inset. So if it does drop, that inset piece isn't gonna break. It's like your phone case. If it's lower than the edge, it's not going to hit that. So that's kind of nice. And then it does have a little plastic straw. These come with their straws just because I know kids like to have, my kids will chew their straws, so I throw them out anyways. So those are the duos. I know some kids don't like the hard plastic sippy. Some don't mind them. My granddaughter isn't real fond of them. My grandson didn't care. Bubbles. That's my zipper. We did. Drying over there? I think so.
Megan Gilly said, okay, what does Nephew Turtle use as a daily carry tumbler?
He has a Rick and Morty and then a wine tumbler that we're going to be putting a design on that he has picked out. He's got one of the original Rick and Morty's. Why do kids chew straws, right? You know what? They grow up to be those adults that chew pen caps. I think it's just like either a nervous habit or,
Mr.
I don't
Turtle
know.
Chews
I like
anything
yeah.
in his mouth.
Yeah, I'm not a chewer. Or they walk around with a toothpick or straw or something. I don't know. I know my kids chewed. Two of them at least did. Just gonna work out some of the excess water underneath these decals because I don't want any bubbles popping up on me later. This cup does not have a coat of epoxy on it, but it does have two very light coats of diamond clear coat on it so that it's got a shine to it so that my edges of my water slides will blend in. You won't see those. If you put a clear water slide on a matte tumbler, a spray painted matte tumbler, you run the risk of your water slide edges being seen. So they should try to blend in with the cup. So just working out some of the extra water on there. And then I'm gonna let this one dry. You don't want to put it in front of a heater to dry because it's going to cause it to crack and wrinkle. You don't want that.
Curl up.
And it'll curl your edges. Bad news. I learned the hard way. So just getting the excess water out, and I'm going to let this air dry, and then we'll put a couple more blood splatters, some crime scene tape, maybe a bloody handprint, or maybe a body chalk outline. So that's pretty cool. Pretty cool.
Miranda said, why? Why do kids chew straws? So annoying. Right? Someone needs to create an indestructible straw for kids.
They probably wouldn't chew the stainless steel ones.
Megan said,
but they are a little big for the smaller tumblers.
Megan said can confirm the pen cap thing because they chew those too.
Yep, they sure do.
And Miranda said that and the end of sippy cups. Yes, they will chew the hell out of the end of a sippy cup.
Yeah. All right, I think I'm gonna try to get this bottom decal on. It's a full wrap bottom that's going on for a Super Mario's cup. I should have had you grab that foil. That's right, we're good. I got it flipped over, it's fine. So we're gonna try to get this one on real quick before my water gets too cold. I'm gonna clean up some of this mess too. And we'll finish up our zipper that we added on. We'll finish gluing the other side down and then trim it.
Jane Fair says, I can't find your email to send you a picture to see if you can do it.
You can send it to Jen at thirstyturtletumblers.com.
Daza Kids, I changed my ultraviolet blue to blue rather than keeping it black.
Oh.
Not sure if we missed something along the way for that one.
Let me see the size of this guy here. And see if he'll go on there. I think he's too small, so that's why I was reprinting. But I know I wanted it to be... No, it's perfect. I'll put that on there too. Sorry, I switched cups real quick because I want to put this Hoosier decal on. It's little, I don't want to lose it.
So folks, we kind of talked about what we might be doing on Saturday, our live. If you guys stay tuned tomorrow and keep up to date with our TikTok page, we may send out kind of like a PSA that says, here's the ingredients you're gonna need for the drink for Saturday night, if we have time to do that. Otherwise, you just might have to do it kind of off the cuff on Saturday night when we show you what we're making.
Right. My teeth are coming up.
As a kid said, I was saying I made a cup but changed the colors of the wording.
Gotcha.
And also, we didn't do a drawing tonight, so more than likely, we'll probably have something planned for Saturday, maybe. So make sure you tune in Saturday. We usually start those sometime between...
We're trying to do them around 8.
Between 8 and 8:30, we should be live.
Yeah. I knew that was going to do that to me, but I wanted to get it off of the backing because it was just going to pull that up. I wasn't sure if I was going to like this water slide on here. So we're going to check it out, see how I like it. It may get pulled right off. I'm loving the idea of it, but I'm not sure I'm going to love the look of it. So,
Dusty, it should be sometime between 8 and 8:30 on Saturday. Plus, we've got your University of Louisiana cups under epoxy right now.
Yeah, I showed them the one.
Yep.
And then the other two are over there. This thing is going to drive me crazy. I don't know about this. I'm just not sure. I think I might have to do this where I paint it white. Because I'm not sure I'm liking the transparency on this part. And it's not going to go around straight for sure because this is a tapered cup. And I did not work this image. So it is going to go up, but I have a green base. So I'm kind of hoping that'll help me.
Dusty said, this weekend catch the beginning. Week after, I'll have to sneak in while I'm at work.
They'll probably run like an hour and a half, 2 hours. So you'll have time. You'll have time. And like I said, you'll catch the replay too. So I know it's more fun to be here like in the moment, but because the replay, you don't see the comments. You just see me answering questions. You're like, what the hell is she, who's she talking to? How high up are you going there, buddy?
I think that looks really cool.
I just have to see if it's gonna let me work these wrinkles out, because I'm not liking the way it's laying. I should have warped the bottom of it. I don't know why I didn't.
Dusty said, joys of having two jobs. Deb Pity Mama of two said, 3 to 4, next thing we know, it'll be last call.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna dig, I'm not digging this. I'm just not liking the way it's gonna lay for me.
The idea is cool.
Yeah, I think I just need to warp the image so that it, well, hold on, I'm working some of these wrinkles out. Give me a second. Maybe it is going to work. Because there is going to be some other decals going on this. I might be able to blend that bottom in. Let's get this trimmed up. See if we can make it look all right. I'm not sure I'm going to like the way this is going to end. That's what I'm worried about. Because he needs to be straight. Let's stretch him a little bit. See if we can straighten him out. It's the power of Plasti Dip, folks. Good layer of Plasti Dip on your water slides. And you can straighten him out a little bit. Okay, I'm not as upset about this as I thought I was. I know, my knife is pretty sharp. Sorry, I got my serious face on.
That just joined, the cup that she's working on right now is a
Mario Brothers. Yeah.
Mario Brothers cup. Mida 614 said, I bet it's going to look amazing when you're done.
I hope so. I'm really okay. I'm not upset with this wrap. Thought I was going to be upset with it, but I'm actually okay with that. We're going to blend that in. And just the little scenery that's kind of going on there. But
Dusty said, trying to grade papers while watching, not grading much.
You know, it's funny, I saw a TikTok of a professor that said grading papers, and he was standing at the top of his stairs, on each of the stairs starting with an F, D minus, D, all the way down to the bottom at like A plus. And he golf swung all the reports, and whatever step they landed on, that was the grade they got. I thought it was hysterical.
Deputy Mama of Two, you are your own worst critic. Your work is phenomenal.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Miranda
says,
we are
all our own worst critics. Yes.
Miranda says, it looks good. I love Mario Brothers.
So these guys are going to go on here. Probably right about there. So they're going to go on there. I'm going to cut them out. And then we got a couple coins, because you got to have coins and some more bricks. And then we got to have him on there, because he's a turtle. Got to put him on there. So he's going to go on there. So, yeah, I'm okay with this right now.
I think it looks good.
I'm going to let this dry, and then I'll go in with the other decals, because I want to make sure that this looks good before I put all those decals down. Make sure it dries nice. Can you grade that way? Wouldn't that be fun? 4!
Dusty said, high school students want to know why they made that grade, so I can't do that. Well, actually, you could. You just have to come up with a really good story.
Just send them the TikTok link. All right, this looks actually pretty good. I'm pretty happy.
Mirandar said, "Where's Yoshi?"
I don't know who is this Yoshi? Is the turtle Yoshi? I thought the turtle was Yoshi. My kid was playing Kung Fu Chaos, not Super Mario Brothers.
Kinky Dynasty, I ordered on January 7th. Do you know when I'll get to my order? No rush, I just want to know.
What cup is it? Because I may have the base pulled, or I may have the base started, or I may have it a little bit further along.
Because no matter what, we can't get to all of our cups on a live. So there's a lot of them that are in production that...
Behind the scenes.
Yeah. And
Yoshi's the green dinosaur. You know what? I'm going to have to see if I can find him to put him on there.
Canyon just sent us an attachment of Yoshi.
Thanks, bud.
Machine Gun Kelly with the name Jesse on it. Oh, we got a lot of Machine Gun Kellys going.
Yeah. I have the list of all the names that I have to do. I'm trying to create them like the Machine Gun Kelly
album
font
cover.
Like that's on their cover. But that's not super easy to find all the letters. So I've been searching for a font that's really similar so I can get those names cut. But I did get more of the UV changing vinyl in for it. So those will be coming out pretty soon. You'll probably start to see those on the Turner.
Silver Girl Lisa, what is your lead time? I have an order with you.
My current turnaround time right now is about 6 to 8 weeks. I got a couple cups that are a little bit longer than that, but some of them creatively just take a little bit longer, but usually you'll see those coming along on the lives. So that's where we're gonna stop with this one for right now. And then we're going to add the other decals. These are stickers, which is cool. I did printable vinyl on those.
Almost 11 o'clock.
Woohoo! Alrighty. Was that all I can do? Well, no, I need a full. That's pretty much all I got. You guys come and hang out with us on Saturday. I'm probably going to be doing a full wrap Harry Potter map. It'll probably get wrapped before then, but you might catch me doing the footprints on it. The disappearing and appearing footprints.
Megan Gilly said, I'm the longer cup time. I'm a mess. Well, stop asking for weird things, Megan. We can get them out a lot quicker.
You know what? It's funny that you actually say that because...
You have her saying ready.
I do. This is your saying cut out. It's going on this rose gold metallic vinyl on your dumb cup to match that glitter rose gold on it. So it's gonna be really cool. Do I notify you when I'm about to work on it? The newer forms, I got your TikTok names on them. I'm trying to do that, but it's really a lot easier if you just kind of check in and say, what cup's you working on tonight? Or are you gonna be working on this cup? And I can let you know.
Or if you just check in anytime during the week, we can probably let you know.
I'm trying to kind of get a schedule ahead so that I know which cups I'm doing on which lives so that I can give you guys that notice. She may need to waste my glitter.
Kinky Dynasty, would you work with me if I wanted a custom cup with a design you haven't done yet? Of course.
Almost all the cups are custom cups that I haven't done before. Like I've never done a group Venom cup before. I've done a group cup, but not a group Venom cup. Couple orders are like the Marvin the Martian, or just people saw an order and they really like them. MGK cups, you'll see. A lot of times I don't do those on the lives only because you've seen me do those cups before. So mostly what you're seeing on the lives are cups that I haven't made before. So yeah.
Silva Girl Lisa said, okay, we didn't do a formal. We did all this by email and then you sent me an invoice. Yep, that's usually how it works.
Yep. And then if I have any questions, I'll send a response back to you, or Mr. Troll will get back to you after he's talked to me about it. And be like, how do we want to do this? What do you think about this or whatever? So if I'm confident with the Tumblr and moving forward with it, you'll get an invoice. Do I prefer to find my own images or you to provide them? I...
It depends on the image. If it's your business logo or it's a very specific image that you want me to use, if it's something I can use, I will let you know. But most of the images are ones that I will find or I've purchased license for or so forth.
Jaden1K12, any more giveaways?
Not tonight, but there probably is going to be one on Saturday. That was all the tumblers I got to work on tonight. I got to get that Easter one done, so that might be on Saturdays.
Yeah, we've talked a lot about, guys, the subscription box that we're going to be doing. So we're trying to get as many of those completed as possible so we can show you what they're going to look like, just to make it that much more appealing for you to order the subscription boxes.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Missed a few comments. I'm sorry. Okay. Jaden, when K-12 said, I'm coming.
Virgil F. Clark,
see you on Saturday.
Said, you are awesome.
If you are not over 21, then you'll have to make a different beverage. I saw those hearts. Thank you. You got entered into our monthly drawing for gifters. Thank you so much.
Silver Girl Lisa said, mine is a business logo.
Yeah, then that's a different story. Yes, you can send that over to me, and I'll let you know if it's a logo that I can work with. All right, I'll be purchasing a new cup for the boyfriend. Awesome. Thank you, King Tenacity. I appreciate that. And is it Ver? I can't read that one. Ver Gilfred, Gilf Colark. You're Pitbull awesome.
Pitbull Monty, I wish I would have thought about it earlier. I would have had another cup made for my wife for her 27th birthday.
Better late than never.
Dusty said, when you get to it, I found the animal prints from Pinterest Tattoos.
Interesting. You have to send it over to me and let me know which...
That's for her paw print ones, yeah, that she wants.
Yeah, send those over because I've been doing a little bit of research on those and I haven't found one that has jumped at me yet.
Kinky Dynasty, you fuel my cup addiction. We like that.
Remember, tumblers are accessories and they're the best accessory you can have. They're going to last for a long time. I'm obsessed with them too, so don't worry about it. I have to keep sending them out the door though. That's what's hard.
Miranda, I'll see you Saturday with my watermelon margaritas.
Awesome.
I need a watermelon cup for that. Miranda, have you not seen our watermelon
who can
cup?
Make a watermelon cup.
We've got a tick. If you go back about 6 months, you'll find the TikTok for our watermelon cups.
You want it as a tattoo, but it'll never happen. You never know. My mom was, 65 for her 65th birthday. She got her first tattoo of Tinkerbell. I paid for it.
Kinky Dynasty, gasp. No horror movie cup?
No, I switched it out. So, you know, my Christmas tree's still up. So at least I moved into at least a more relative holiday from October to Christmas to Valentine's Day. I'm hoping to have a St. Patrick's Day one here soon. Yeah, we should be good then, Sylvia. Girl Lisa. Silver girl Lisa. We should be good to go then. All right, guys, that's all I got for tonight. Unless you got any last minute questions, we will see you on Saturday around 8:30. Come hang out with us. We're going to be making drinks on the live, and then we're going to make a tumbler to go with the drinks. So it'll be kind of cool. Plus, I'll be working on other tumblers. So you're going to see me working on some other cups. All righty, guys. Thanks for joining me. Have a great night tonight.